Det er fint, ja. Det er bra.
We met in high school.
Yeah.
When we were 16 years old, 17. And then we moved to Oslo and we started to play in this band together with a friend of ours. And then Eirik had this school project at the university where he was going to record this song.
Production exam.
Do the production, yeah. And then he asked if we could do a song together. And then after that, it just...
Good.
We just kept going.
What do you need to bring on tour that you can't live without?
For sure, headphones.
Yeah.
And now I got Stoy cancelling.
Stoy
cancelling. Stoy cancelling. I had to say that again.
Noise cancelling. Yeah, you got noise cancelling. That's very good.
What's your connection to 777 music?
I met Tim many years ago, and I remember the first time I met Tim. It's actually a really funny story because I was new in the music industry, and then, you know, I needed some tips and some advice, and then I asked him randomly, like, hey, can I meet you and just like talk to you about stuff and give him some advice? And he was like, sure. I came into his office and I just started to bleed from my nose like crazy, and like, so the whole meeting was basically me sitting like this with paper up my nose and just like talking to him. And he thought it was so funny. He laughed and laughed and laughed. So like later on, we've been like emailing. I've like been saying, hey I'm the girl who bled on your couch.
You made an impression then.
I made a very strong impression. Ulyssa is two really, really great guys, and they basically ask different musicians that they know or like to like do collaborations with other musicians or try to do like a cool project with them. Like they asked us to do a Bob Marley cover record, which we did, and it was so much fun.
How was it working with Bruce Hornsby, and what's the story of how that happened?
Yeah, that was Eirik who sent an email and was like, yeah, we want to do like a collaboration between Bruce Hornsby and these Brazilian guys who did more like a house music, electronic music.
Yeah.
And then he asked if I could do vocals. So basically, you know, all the tracks got sent around to all of the different musicians, and it turned out really great. It's a really it's a really fun record. Yeah. Yeah.
Ah, a lot of stuff has happened since last time we released music. While we were on tour, COVID hit, and then we got back home the day everything shut down in Norway. And then we both moved to Northern Norway, so that's happened. You had another kid, I had a concussion, and I was sick for a year, so it's quite a lot that happened.
You got married.
I got married, yeah, true. It's many things, yeah. And we managed to make a new album.
Yeah. Michael is the main character of the album. He's kind of, you know, all of the people who are longing home or has some kind of, you know, longing for another life. I read this book when I moved to north of Norway that meant a lot to me, and the guy who wrote the book is called Michael, or Mikael. So it's kind of also a reference to him.
Do you have any favorites of the new record?
I think Out in the Backyard, I think, is my favorite. It kind of sums up the record very well.
Sometimes it can be hard to choose a favorite between the songs because they have such different qualities, and I like all of them, and they have...
Oh, it's like a bullshit answer. I like all the songs.
I do, but I like... I really like the one we did with Emil Karlsson, actually.
The Eirik?
Yeah, the Eirik.
Yeah.
I think that has a really nice nerve to it. what's been really fun with this record is that we've involved also more of our band musicians. So Erlend Ivar has joined for a lot for the writing, and also Martin from Popopo has been writing a lot with us. So that's been really fun writing for this record, that we sort of try to make our musical universe a bit bigger and include more people in the writing process. And I think that's actually worked really well.
I agree.